The moon has a side it never shows us. Humans have flown by it to take pictures and crashed a couple of probes into it, but we've never landed a spacecraft on its surface to get up close and personal with our satellite's hidden half. Until now. First though, some clarification. Sometimes the side of the moon is referred to as the dark side of the moon. That's inaccurate. The moon is tidally locked with the Earth, meaning one side is always facing us, but the side facing away from us still gets sunshine. So the more correct term is the far side of the moon, and dark side of the moon is just a killer Pink Floyd album. China's Chang'e 4 probe, which landed in January of 2019, will be the first spacecraft to poke and prod and study this hidden side of the moon. But why go there at all? A big reason for this mission is, well, because we can. As the name implies, Chang'e 4 is not the first of its kind. The first Chang'e mission, named after the goddess of the moon from Chinese mythology, was an orbiter that launched in late 2007, orbiting the moon for a year and 4 months before its planned impact in March of 2009. Chang'e 2 was built as a backup to Chang'e 1, and it launched in 2010. It orbited the moon before setting off for the Earth and Sun's second Lagrange point, and then continued on to fly by an asteroid in 2012. Busy little craft. Chang'e 3 was China's first lunar lander, and it touched down in 2013. Along with the stationary probe was a little rover about 3/4 the mass of the Opportunity rover on Mars. The rover was named Yutu, meaning Jade Rabbit. Going back to Chinese myth, a rabbit was the goddess Chang'e's only company out there on the moon. Yutu set a record as the longest-lived rover on the moon. It even discovered a new type of moon rock that helped scientists better understand the moon's history of volcanism. Which brings us to the present day. Like Chang'e 2, Chang'e 4 was built as a backup in case the Chang'e 3 mission failed, but it didn't. So why not go bigger and bolder with the spare? With an upgraded suite of instruments and experiments, Chang'e 4's mission became to explore the far side of the moon. The exact destination is near the South Pole, inside an enormous crater. The mineral composition there is different than other parts of the moon, and may be from the inside of the moon that were brought up by an impact. To study their makeup, Chang'e 4 has spectrometers, along with ground-penetrating radar and cameras. The craft will also study the effects of solar wind on the lunar surface, and it's brought along plant seeds and silkworm eggs to see if they can grow in the moon's low gravity. Finally, its place on the far side of the moon makes for an ideal spot to test the feasibility of radio astronomy from there, since the moon blocks out noise and interference coming from Earth. Of course, if the moon is blocking radio signals, that makes getting data back from the lander and driving an expensive RC moon car a little more challenging. To solve that, the Chinese launched a satellite in May of 2018 that is currently orbiting Earth-Moon Lagrange Point 2. With the relay in place and Chang'e 4 touching down, we can finally learn more about the hidden side of our nearest celestial neighbor. Like science in your day? Well, you should subscribe. And although we're sending a rover to the moon, we actually have a complete map of the moon's surface, which is a lot more than we can say about the mapping of our oceans. But how close are we to a complete ocean map? Check out our video here and make sure to keep coming back to Seeker. Thanks for watching.